ceremonies, and also in the course of that, to extend your welcome on behalf of the chairman and the directors and directors and all the staff of our company scattered from right around Australia. So on behalf of all those people who make up our Rex family from around Australia, I'd like to welcome all of you here today to this our graduation ceremony of class of 17 and 18 of the Australian Airline Pilot Academy. Now, in welcoming you, I'd like to particularly welcome our guest of honour, Barnaby Joyce, the Minister for Agriculture. He's also a member for New England, which is Armadale Tamworth. Barnaby's here today with a note from his mother to say why he's late. And also, I'd like to officially extend a welcome to our Mayor of Royal Wongan City Council, Councillor Rod Kendall, which is, of course, a famous name in aviation. And speaking of that, I'd also like to welcome our Rex ambassadors who join us today. Iris Kendall and her husband Don Kendall, the late Don Kendall, founded Kendall Airlines here in Warren. And of course, Kendall forms half of the foundation stone that now makes up Rex. And sitting next to Iris, Max and Laurel Hazelton. And of course, Max and Laurel founded the other half of our foundation stone, Hazelton Airlines, just near Orange, and many years ago, 1953, I think, was it, Max, something around there. And then next to Irish is Wally Finn, one of our ambassadors who flies our flag very proudly for us in Dubbo, and we're very pleased to have Wally here today. And next to Wally is a very good friend of his from Dubbo Company, Murray Taylor, who's joined us today. And next to Murray in the pink is the patron saint of Rex Airlines, Kay Hart, who of course was a member for Riverina, and she was succeeded by one of our other very special guests of honour today, Michael McCoy, who is seated next to the Mayor, and next to Barnaby Joyce, who is a member for Riverina. He's also the Parliamentary Secretary for Finance in the Federal Government. Michael, like Kay, has been a fantastic supporter of our airlines. We make Kay our patron saint.
Well, first of all, welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Australian Airline Pilot Academy. two screening processes and two interviews generally just to get the start on the course. So it's not a single program. Those who are accepted are chosen not purely on academics or previous learning experience, but individuals that we think will be good employees and also good colleagues in the company. I've heard some of our other managers express it that we should look for people that you'd be happy to spend 8 to 10 hours walking in a fairly small room with that you can trust. So we look for those that are not only going to be good pilots, but will represent themselves, their colleagues, and the company in a manner that we think is appropriate to deal with our customers and with each other. That's why these graduation fairs are here today, because we believe they have these qualities. If you're a parent or a family member or a partner of someone who's graduated today, you should be very proud of them. The REACH Cadet program is not easy. Anyone who completes it has attained a very high standard of flying and flying knowledge. And they've worked very hard and studied hard, plus demonstrated a fair amount of self-discipline and sacrifice to be sitting in those chairs today. I personally take some pride in what we do at AAPAS as chairman. Not only do we teach cadets to fly, most cadets, I think, experience some change in who they are themselves whilst they're here at APA. APA's primary goal, for those who don't know, is to make pilots for the REACH group. Since 2008, in November, when we started the program in the REACH group, we've graduated 183 cadets, with 95% of the current REACH first officers being graduates of the REACH program. And 23 of them now hold commands in the REACH group as well as captains. I'd like to thank our instructors, our engineers, our staff for all their efforts. Our being here today would not be possible without their personal commitment and sometimes sacrifice to achieve what is this day's graduating class. I'd like to congratulate the graduating courses for their success in being the best of us. And ladies and gentlemen, please enjoy the ceremony today, and you're very welcome here at AAPA. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dale Hall, and I extend a welcome to a number of you today. I'd like to continue extending some welcomes to some other special guests who are joining us today on this occasion. And I would particularly like to extend a welcome to representatives of the Queensland Government Department of Main Roads, Transport and Main Roads, who travel all the way from Brisbane to be here with us today. And of course, REACH operates to 24 destinations in Queensland, and so we're very thrilled that somebody from the department who oversees that area of the department's activity has joined us today from Brisbane. And I also extend a welcome to the representatives of Sydney Flight College who joined us today as well. It's great to have you here with us on this special occasion. But this special occasion, ladies and gentlemen, is made that much more special because we have a very important and honoured guest joining us today who will be addressing us in a few moments' time, and we'll be making presentations to the cadets later on during this ceremony. I speak in particular, of course, to Honourable Barnaby Joyce, the Minister for Agriculture in our federal government. He's a member for New England. He was elected as a member of the House of Representatives in September 2013 in that seat of New England. Barnaby comes from that region originally. He'd been diverted in his true path of life and went to Queensland and became a senator in Queensland. And then after several years, I think the 8 years as a senator in Queensland, where he established a huge national profile, he went back to his hometown and became the member for New England. In the meantime, of course, since the last election, he's been elected as the deputy leader of the National Party in the federal parliament and joins with his colleague here today, Michael McCormick, and that party responsibilities. And Barnaby has very generously agreed to come and join us today to add significance to this occasion. And so he's had a most interesting life. Barnaby is educated in the New England electorate, University of New England, the accountancy. Prior to that, he was a bouncer, a farmhand, and took on a number of jobs. He is a person with great life experience. He's brought that life experience to his role as both a senator, a member of the House of Representatives, as Minister for Agriculture, and as Deputy Leader of the National Party. Ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome Barnaby Joyce.
And Kendall family had, in
their passage of water.
And see, since the 1950s, their dream has grown. And pilots are going out. And what they started with, bringing back the 1950s, is still falling forward. For me, it's just great honor to be here. I apologize to my partners. It was yet another pilot's fault.
Nicholas Wheeler.
The Chairman's Award is a scholarship
not every time, but mostly we lead to these graduation ceremonies. And it's based on the highest management assessment and peer appraisal. Peer appraisal, of course, by the fellow guests and instructors. And this is a very prestigious award. And this year, the award, the Chairman's Award, goes to Patrick Wenzel.
Social life, family time, and recreational activities, so as you can clearly focus on your work. The boys' bricks and things have been doing stuff, the others will do it. Nothing is going to hold these guys back from achieving their goals. They love their game and their passion for flying, providing strength to overcome any adverse situation they encounter. The boys and bricks and team never lost sight of their goal, but their house has got it. And trust me, it got tough. There were days when you want to give up, when the workload was too much and it all seemed impossible. There will be days when you didn't want to go flying. If you let it be challenging, as Al said earlier, it's hard here, but it has to be. Because what is required of us is not for your everyday person up in the street. We get put to the test, we get pushed out of it, to see how far we can stretch, to see how much we can take, let's get it. We need to be quick and get on home, we can hop on and see how far you can push yourself. And as a result, we're doing true steps and doing tensions. Our commitment to this program is an expression of our well-being. The training we see at APA provides reasonable stress tolerance with the confidence to place us in their pockets, to fly their customers, work associates, friends, and their families and members throughout the regional program. There's a lot more to being an airline pilot than a lot of people assume. We are amateur weathermen, scientists, and math enthusiasts. We are navigators, leaders, problem solvers. We are required to be patient, polite, and courteous in every circumstance, and we must always remain calm, alert, tackle any unfortunate conditions we may encounter. Standing here in front of you today, as successful students of our bus, as qualified commercial pilots, it's hard not to be in awe of what these young people have accomplished in both the cockpit and within their studies. What our hands and minds can do now is start the art of the robot and the thought possible. Seeing the evolution of my teammates from 7 right eye to UPS is a strong, confident, and capable pilot that has provided me with the confidence to trust each and every one of them with my life as high as a man of any aircraft. I'd now like to take some time to thank those who gave us the opportunity to be a part of this connection. Starting with the recognizing the team for selecting us, for the course, and trusting us to get the job done. I'd like to thank Ivan, Venetia, and Nate for being here for us, and getting us through the course. I'd like to thank the instructors Brett, Luke, Ben, Trey, Jason, Phil, and Robert, who taught us to fly and now their way to answer our questions and provide some materials in the SCS line. I'd like to thank the staff of our office, in particular our staff, Sam Kara, Kara, Andy Reception, and Andy and thanks for being us. I'd also like to thank the patient's parents, family and friends, who provided the most important encouragement to get us through the course. And last but not least, I'd like to thank the cadets of Rec 17, for always being professional, for believing in yourself, and believing in each other. Without your support, I know that I will be standing here today. Gentlemen, for a few minutes in, on a proud day today, thank you all very much. Thank you, sir. Congratulations to you and your colleagues on this occasion. The course captain for the class 18 is Patrick Wentz. Would you please welcome Patrick to speak on behalf of this year?
Thank you. We need rest to identify us who we were in this country, and a big thank you as the rest of us. I think the young stuff here are family and friends and supporters here. Honestly, we need to be able to do this, and we should deserve this opportunity. Thank you.
We believe you are very well prepared to do your duty professionally.
serves the people who live in the community within regional Australia as a citizen. So my congratulations to you. My congratulations on behalf of the board and all the other staff members at our business throughout Australia. We really do welcome you to our family. We wish you all the very best for your future. We think you're going to have a fabulous career ahead of you. So we look forward to seeing you on our flights. I certainly do. And normally when I come to Wonga, one of our first graduates and our first course is the captain of that. That flight that comes here, Andrew Robertson, is here in Wonga now. We know from talking to people like Andrew, who graduated before you, that this is a career that you will enjoy as a family. So all the very best of you. Congratulations to you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to ask the family members of those people who have graduated here today to come forward and to keep upon their family members' lapel the wings that have been awarded to them today, and also the emblems that each of these graduating cadets has also been awarded. So the family members would like to come forward. We're just going to take a 5-minute break whilst the family members do that. At the end of the 5 minutes, and you're asked to sit down and we'll finish our ceremony. So family members, please come forward and finish their wings of the emblems on your family members.
Line yourselves up and Barney, if you could be amongst them, and if our official